The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts, the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophet. Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us then confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. So we say, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sin. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, for the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And so the collect for today. Almighty God, you've made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless till they find their rest in you. Pour your love into our hearts and draw us to yourself. And so bring us at last to your heavenly city, where we shall see you face to face. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our first reading.
For the first reading is Numbers 11, 4-6, 10-16, 24-29. There were foreigners travelling with the Israelites. They had a strong craving for meat, and even the Israelites themselves began to complain. If only we could have some meat. In Egypt we used to eat all the fish we wanted, and it cost us nothing. Remember the cucumbers, the watermelons, the leeks, the onions and the garlic we had. But now our strength is gone. There is nothing at all to eat, nothing but this manna, day after day. Moses heard all the people complaining as they stood around in groups at the entrances of their tents. He was distressed because the Lord had become angry with them. And he said to the Lord, "Why have you treated me so badly? Why are you displeased with me? Why have you given me the responsibility for all these people? I didn't create them or bring them to birth. Why should you ask me to act like a nurse and carry them in my arms like babies all the way to the land you promised to their ancestors? Where could I get enough meat for all these people? They keep whining and asking for meat. I can't be responsible for all these people by myself. It's too much for me. If you're going to treat me like this, have pity on me and kill me, so that I won't have to endure your cruelty any longer." The Lord said to Moses, "Assemble 70 respected men who were recognized as leaders of the people. Bring them to me at the tent of my presence and tell them to stand there beside you." So Moses went out and told the people what the Lord had said. He assembled 70 of the leaders and placed them around the tent. Then the Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to them. He took some of the spirit he'd given to Moses and gave it to the 70 leaders. When the spirit came on them, they began to shout like prophets, but not for long. Two of the 70 leaders, Aldad and Medad, had stayed in the camp and had not gone out to the tent. There in the camp, the spirit came on them, and they too began to shout like prophets. A young man ran out to tell Moses what Aldad and Medad were doing. Then Joshua, son of Nun, who had been Moses' helper since he was a young man, spoke up and said to Moses, "Stop them, sir." Moses answered, "Are you concerned about my interests? I wish that the Lord would give his spirit to all his people and make all of them shout like prophets." This is the word of the Lord.
The second reading comes from the letter of St. James, chapter 5, verses 13-20. Are any among you in trouble? They should pray. Are any among you happy? They should sing praises. Are any among you sick? They should send for the elders of the church, who will pray for them and rub olive oil on them in the name of the Lord. This prayer, made in faith, will heal the sick. The Lord will restore them to health, and the sins they have committed will be forgiven. So then, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you will be healed. The prayer of a good person has a powerful effect. Elijah was the same kind of person as we are. He prayed earnestly that there would be no rain, and no rain fell on the land for 3.5 years. Once again he prayed, and the sky poured out its rain and the earth produced crops. My friends, if any of you wander away from the truth and another one brings you back again, remember this. Whoever turns a sinner back from the wrong way will save that sinner's soul from death and bring about the forgiveness of many sins. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John said to him, "Teacher, we saw a man who was driving out demons in your name, and we told him to stop, because he doesn't belong to our group." "Do not try to stop him," Jesus told them, "because no one who performs a miracle in my name will be able to soon afterwards say evil things about me. Whoever is not against us is for us. I assure you that anyone who gives a drink of water because you belong to me will certainly receive a reward. If anyone should cause one of these little ones to lose faith in me, it would be better for that person to have a large millstone tied around the neck and be thrown into the sea. So if your hand makes you lose your faith, cut it off. It's better for you to enter life without a hand than to keep both hands and go off to hell, to the fire that never goes out. And if your foot makes you lose your faith, cut it off. It's better for you to enter life without a foot than to keep both feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eye makes you lose your faith, take it out. It's better for you to enter the kingdom of God with only one eye than to keep both eyes and be thrown into hell. There the worms that eat them will never die, and the fire that burns will never be put out. Everyone will be purified by fire as a sacrifice is purified by salt. Salt is good, but if it loses its saltiness, how can you make it salty again? Have the salt of friendship among yourselves and live in peace with one another. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Father, we thank you for your word this morning. Touch us, we pray, by your Spirit. Amen. Well, the book of Numbers, it's about a journey, and what a journey. Off they go from Egypt into the wilderness. Free from captivity, they've got foreigners with them as well, God-fearers they would be, rather than Jews. They were an interesting bunch. They weren't that keen on the stuff of God, his food. They wanted all the good stuff. They wanted cucumbers and fish and stuff like that. And how many of us with church, how many of us with anywhere, "Oh, it's not like home, it's different." We're the foreign rabble, and that's the word they use in the Bible. This rabble that followed, that came with them. They weren't up for much of the God stuff at all. You know how many people, when set free, as they were from captivity in Egypt, we who are set free from the power of sin and death, how many of us soon forget this first love and long for home? Oh, we love the things we used to do. When I became a Christian, 10th of April 1974 was just coming up at the time. It was the 9th, the day before that birthday. And you know, I became a Christian and I thought it was great. The story of Jesus and the things he did, they were going to take me on a wilderness journey into the promised land. But then I was told, don't go drinking at the rugby club and certainly don't come back for the service on a Sunday morning, having come straight from the club where everybody's been drinking. Luckily, I don't get drunk, so I was all right. But the beer, when you have to drink the pint and put the glass on your head, it does tend to leave an aroma. The beer was a bit of a problem. And the fact is that I started coming to the evening services because you can't get on the water at 10 o'clock and row with the rowing club and do church. I had to make challenges. The things, the promises, the hopes, the freedom from sin were great. But the old stuff draws you back. And that's what was happening in this Numbers story. And Moses, as he does quite a few times, he's a bit of a drama queen, really, isn't he? Number of times he utters what I call the clergy prayer. And he turns around and says, oh God, why have you given me these people? So many members of the clergy have said to me, they've said that over their congregation so many times. Why me? What have I done? Well, you said, yes, I'll be a vicar. They gave you this to remind you that you put the sheep over your neck and carry them home. That's why. Oh, look at this lot. What a rabble. I can't keep doing this. Oh, why don't you just kill me? And God says, tell you what, mate, go and find 70 people. I'll put the Spirit on them to share the responsibility. The church is looking at reshaping its ministry at the moment, and we're looking for people to come and stand. Recently, I watched a video and the bishop said, we need you all to tell your wardens and your readers and your church members that they're going to have the privilege of running the church because we're going to sack you. Look, well, make wait till you retire, honestly, most places. And you know, the thing is, it's all well and good saying we want the people to come and do the job. Someone said to me a few weeks back, you know, anyone could do your job, you just read the words. And that's true, that's exactly what we do. We read the words and everybody is impressed. Actually, you can't do this job. You can't be a believer without understanding that the Spirit of the living God is in you, on you, and with you, and enabling. Each one of us has a calling. And Moses said, you know what? I don't like this calling. God said, go and find your 70 people, and I'll put the Spirit on them. And they prophesy, and two of them are doing the stuff, and Joshua comes up and says, see what they're doing? And Moses goes, I wish they were all doing it. I wish the Spirit would fall on every member of every church, that they'd be filled with the Spirit and they'd prophesy, that they'd do the stuff, they'd be the stuff. And that's the message today. First and foremost, as you journey, stop looking at where you've come from and look at where you're going. Look at the things God has given you, the things God has set you free from. Captivity in Egypt, captivity from sin. And don't look at the world and wish to be like it. Don't look at the world and long for the things you had. And having seen some of my clergy colleagues, they certainly don't. I've got a few of mine who have their clergy friends. They go out and next month they find a member of the congregation driving them for the 12-year ban until it leaves. They're not always filled with the right spirit. But trust that God, as with Moses, will fill you, will use you, will bring people to work alongside you. I am the world's second laziest vicar. I'm certainly the town's second laziest vicar. I want to encourage everybody to come and do the stuff. And if I work hard enough, eventually everyone will be doing this and I can sit in the corner and drink Coke and enjoy the service. God's calling you the way God called and anointed the 70 in our story. So it's a really nice thing to think about. Ask yourself, what's God calling me to do today and tomorrow and the day after? Because we're all called to stand shoulder to shoulder and share in the task. Which brings us so nicely on to James. Are you suffering? Then pray. There's a rule in the church that if you're suffering, you moan. But you know, we don't do enough of the praying. We don't do enough when travail, lovely word, isn't it? When trouble comes, we don't pray. We whine, we moan, we go on about it. My father used to tell a joke about a man whose hand was like that. And he said, "Oh Lord, make my hands the same." Bosh. I do wish I hadn't prayed that, he said. And you know, my dad used to think that was funny. He had a row of them. Lazarus came forth and lost his beer money. There were so many Bible jokes. But you know, the biggest joke is that we who should be people of faith do not pray when the going gets tough, when the suffering comes. And God answers. He really does. Are you happy? If you're happy, if you're a proper Christian, you just carry on going, yeah, things are going so well. Sing, praise, worship God. Thank you for what you've given me. You know, I spoke to a lovely lady this week about something or other, and we got talking, and she sent me an email and said, "You know, I haven't been to church for years, but I'm going this Sunday. Because I've realized that there's something there." Things will make you walk away from your faith. And there's that lovely bit in the James that says, if you see someone and they've gone away from the truth, you lead them back. Their sins are covered. Everything is great. But you know, get out of bed and praise. Shema Yisrael, Elokeinu Adonai, Elokeinu Echad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord our God is one. Every good Jewish boy gets out of bed and says that every morning. With Jesus just next to him, saying the same thing. The Lord our God, the Lord is one. They wake with praise on their lips. And someone said, yeah, but that's habit. It is, and habit's great. The things you force yourself to do, when they become habit, become second nature. Then you can force yourself to do something else, like stop moaning. And when you stop moaning and it's a habit, then you can force yourself to do something else, like serve the people around you. And bit by bit, you've got so many good habits. Life is different. And are you ill? Are your friends ill? Then call for the elders of the church. One of the Vineyard composers, songwriters and worship leaders who I really love, and I love his songs, one day wrote a piece called Call for the Elders of the Church, and I had to pray to be able to smile every time they sang it. But you know, it's true. We have prayed for people in this church. We had a blind lady, blind in one eye, and she came and said, you know, things are getting worse, my consultant says. So we said, oh, let's pray. I've normally got an oil in my pocket. I've left it on the desk. There's one in the little ombre behind me. There's another in the car, because you never know when you're going to need Jesus. So we prayed. We anointed and we prayed. And she came back and I said, how's it going? She said, oh, yeah, that eye's getting better. I said, good. Hallelujah. The thing is, I can see the light go on and off in the blind one as well. Don't underestimate God. Don't underestimate the power of prayer. Don't underestimate God's Holy Spirit, for that's what the oil represents, the Spirit of God, as we anoint. We have lost faith in God and miracles. We have lost faith that we have a God who acts. This week we've had all the prophets of Baal and Asherah, and Elijah, go on, have a go, call your God. Nothing happens all day. And he says, oh, make the hole a bit bigger. Fill it with water. And he goes, all right, God. Steps back, bosh. We have a God who answers by fire. But we've forgotten that because we don't believe miracles can happen. We've got out of the habit of praying for the sick. We've got out of the habit of a lovely lady when I was in the church in Hounslow used to pray every Sunday as the warden. But the for the lapsed. I always used to wonder what the lapsed were, but there you go. She means those who don't come to church anymore, but we don't pray for them, we don't talk to them, we don't find out what their needs are. And you know, if you see someone doing something in Jesus' name, whether they go to your church or not, praise God, don't stop them. I love it when Jesus says to John and that lot, what? Don't stop them. You can't do something in God's name, in Jesus' name, and then a minute later be cursing him. They may not look the same as you. They may not smell the same as you. I'm often told that as people move away. But if you serve the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength, if you do the stuff, they may not be the same as you. But hallelujah. And blessed are those who offer a cup of water to one of these little ones, stops them from failing in their faith. That's nice, isn't it? It's always good to give them a cup of water. It's cheaper than a coffee. But then comes the problem. If your hand, your eye, your foot causes you to sin, to lose your faith, chop it off. And there have been people in the past who have done that, taking it literally. I don't think Jesus was actually really encouraging people to chop hands and feet off and poke their eyes out. But you know, there's something in your body that stops you hurting yourself. You ever seen a drunk bloke try to punch himself? He goes, yeah, great. Go on, give it a good go if you're going to. You know, Jesus knows that at the end of the day, we protect ourselves. We don't protect our faith in the same way. If you had a cancerous limb, you'd chop it off. Sin's a cancer, Jesus is saying. And if you can't cure it, then you remove it. You don't need to chop it off, because I know a very, very good surgeon when it comes to the cancer that's sin. He will take care of it. He will remove it. It's a very, very, very interesting procedure. It's called you repent. You turn from your sins. You trust God. You follow him and you open yourself to him. And there's a man called David Watson said weeks before his death, how funny, I prayed for so many people who've been healed. And now I understand that God has healed me. The cancer's still there, but the real problem was something much deeper. As he accepted his illness, he found healing, more healing than mere medicine can do. So for your lost ones, for the people who moan, for the people who are lost on the journey, for the people who wonder who's going to run the church, God is, but he's going to use you. He used 70 in the story at the beginning. He used as many as he can get in the church of today. So love the Lord your God, follow him. Look at the people around you. If you see someone causing a child to stumble, to be damaged, to be broken, don't look at our history in the church and in the football clubs and rugby clubs and choirs and everything. Everywhere you look, people are abusing the weak, the fragile, the vulnerable, the young. It's not a church thing, all this child sexual abuse stuff. It's what happens when the world creeps into anybody, any person, anything. So cut that cancer out. Be vigilant, be aware. Protect the young and the old, the vulnerable, the poor, the strange, the mad. And this afternoon, the Arsenal supporters as we play Tottenham. We need, don't shake your head, Wendy. We need to realise where the needs are in the people around us and in ourselves and to act with God's love in all things. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for a journey that causes Moses to put his beard out and ask God to zap him. For James, who knows that all we have to do is call for the people with the oil, to touch the sick, to sing songs when we're happy, to pray when we're troubled. And Father, we thank you that we are called to bless those who serve you, no matter where or what they are. Help us, Father, to have open arms, eyes that are wide open, to see all things, and hearts that are big enough to embrace every difference. We ask this, Father God, in your most amazing name. Amen. And so let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So we come to a time of prayer.
Father, we come this morning before you, our God, who is able to do immeasurably more than we can ever hope or imagine. A God in whom we put our faith and our trust, and we give our lives willingly. And Father, we hear your call this morning to us to be faithful, to be your people, to be your hands, your feet, your voice, your love, your grace, and your power to those around us. So we come, Lord, in humility, knowing that we can do nothing ourselves, but we can do everything through Christ who strengthens us, and through the Spirit who dwells within us and empowers and enables us. So Father, this morning we pray for our world, a world that is troubled, that is changing daily around us. We pray for Germany as they go through their elections and wonder what the future will be without Angela Merkel. Father, we pray for her successor, that they would bring stability. They would continue her policies of openness and reaching out and being part of the global community, not just looking inwardly to their own needs. We pray for Afghanistan, where reports of people being hanged and bodies left hanged in the streets as a warning to others are being circulated as the Taliban increase their rule and their hold on that country. Lord, we pray for those who will be fearful for their lives. We pray that we may not forget them. We may continue to lobby on their behalf, to pray for them, knowing that our prayers are effective and you will bring change. Lord, we pray for the tensions between China and other countries, for China's expansion policies, for the countries who are grouping together to try and curtail those ambitions. Lord, we pray that we would all be able to live together in peace in this your world. We pray for Haiti and for the Canaries as they both live with the consequences of natural disaster. We pray for those who have been deported from the US to Haiti and are fearful for their lives. Lord, we pray for justice, for compassion, and for truth. We pray for the situation in Israel, as Israel has conducted a raid in the West Bank and killed several Palestinians, for the ongoing tensions. Lord, we pray for peace, that Israeli and Palestinian would be able to live together and occupy that land. Lord, that we would all be willing to make room for others, that we would all be willing to share this world and its resources so that all can be safe, secure, provided for. And we know that can only come when our hearts and minds are changed. So come and change us, Lord, we ask. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we pray for our own country, for the panic buying that has swept across, for those who have hoarded petrol, for those who are unable to get any because of the selfish actions of others. Lord, we pray for the part that the media has played in whipping up these tensions. We pray for our government as they try to calm the situation and reassure the populace. We pray for the background issues, the lack of HGV drivers, the tensions and pressures that have come because of Brexit and because of COVID and because of other things. Rather than arguing about the cause, Lord, help us to find a solution. Help us to be the solution where we can be, to share what we have, to make sure that those around us do not go without while we have more than we need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we pray for the people we know, those who are ill today. We respond to your word to pray for them, to anoint them with oil, to pray in faith, knowing that you are a God who answers with fire, with power, with healing. Lord, forgive us for our lack of faith. Help us to trust in you again as we lift those we know. We bring them to you humbly, asking only that you be God in their lives. For you are good, you are faithful, and you are able. Lord, in your mercy, hear our Father, as we pray for those who mourn today, we remember the family and friends of Sabina, the young teacher who was murdered walking from her home. We pray for the family of the 12-year-old who died in an accident at the Snow Dome. We pray for all those who have lost loved ones this week through accident, through violence, through illness, or perhaps through old age. Lord, we pray for the family of Madge Jackson, giving you thanks for her life, for the memories that she leaves behind. We pray for all who mourn today, all who will think of loved ones, perhaps feel sad. Lord, may they know the comforting presence that comes with knowing we are reassured and assured that there is a resurrection, that there is life beyond this, and that we will be united, reunited in your glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Peace to you from God, our Heavenly Father. Peace from his Son, Jesus Christ, who is our peace. Peace from the Holy Spirit, the life giver. The peace of the triune God be always with you and also with you. So we offer one another a sign of peace here and wherever you are. So peace be with you guys. Good to see you. Peace be with you. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, at all times and in all places, to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For he is your living Word. Through him you've created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you've freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born of a woman and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. For great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. And as our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one body. So draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, and share your bread with sin. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord, we pray that your grace may always precede and follow us, and make us continually to be given to all good works through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
And I've learned I won't play it as fast as we used to sing it. You can breathe in this time.
If I am
You know, the Beatles don't know what they missed. So the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and those you love, now and always. Amen. Let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Thank you for being with us here. And wherever you are, whenever you are watching this, have a great week. Bye. Thanks, guys.